Good morning, everyone. Can you hear me? Hi. All right. So earlier we asked from which agency are you? And I'm seeing responses. So later we will recognize your organizations. But for now, I'd like to say good morning and welcome to the webinar on productivity and quality improvement in the new normal. So, first and foremost, we have participants from the Polytechnic University of the Philippines. Good morning. From the DOST-NCR, University of Eastern Philippines. From the PRC in Cordillera Administrative Region. From the DSWD Field Office 1. From DPWH Bohol. So we have participants from both Luzon and Visayas. I'm not sure if we have participants from Mindanao. We'll see about that. All right, from DSWDs, from PUP, from CHED NCR, from PCSO, from Philippine Science High School, Hospital ng Palawan, okay. We have DA BPI Plant Quarantine Service in Dumaguete. So magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat and I hope this will be an enriching 1 hour to all of us. All right, without further ado, I would like to introduce to you our resource person. So, alam ko excited na kayo and you want this 1 hour to be filled with learning. Ano po? So, if you are ready, let's begin. Our resource person for today's webinar is a graduate of Bachelor of Arts in Behavioral Science from the University of Santo Tomas. She also has a diploma in training development in management from the De La Salle University and master's in industrial relations major in human resource development from the University of the Philippines, Diliman. She also attended a professional enrichment course in the School of Continuing and Professional Studies in the University of Virginia in Virginia, USA. Our resource person for today is the current Program Director of the Productivity and Quality Training Office, or PQTO, of DAP's Productivity and Development Center since 2016. She served as a member of the Steering Committee on the study meeting for the Certification Program for Productivity Practitioners Basic Course last 2017 in Hanoi, Vietnam. Some of her fields of expertise are knowledge management, basic and advanced productivity and quality, and business excellence. So before I formally introduce to you our resource person, I would like to remind everyone that if you have questions during the lecture, please use the question and answer, the Q&A panel on the right part of your screens or in your mobile phones, and use the chat box for your comments and for greetings. So that's it, everyone. Let us all welcome Miss Maria Teresa A. Agustin. Good morning, Ma'am Tess.
Good morning, Jel. And good morning to everyone. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Okay, so welcome to our webinar on productivity and quality improvement in the new normal. Okay, so to start with our session, okay, let me give you a rundown of our session objectives so that at the end of this, you'll be able to discuss the concepts of productivity and quality improvement, identify the tools to improve productivity and quality, and recognize the relevance of productivity and quality improvement in the new normal, no, as we are transitioning, no, to the new normal. Okay, so let me start with this simple exercise for you to think about. When do you feel productive and when do you feel unproductive? So you may just have this as a mental exercise for you, something to think about, to ponder upon, so that whatever it is that makes you productive or that makes you unproductive, so ano kaya yon, that forms part of the factors affecting our productivity. So whether that refers to the feeling that you have, that you feel productive, feel unproductive, so yon. So it may be the facilitating and the hindering factors. It may be internal factors or external factors that affect your productivity as an individual or as an employee. Okay, so productivity can mean different things to different people. At the DAP, as the National Productivity Organization, we have this various perspective or concepts of productivity. So we take productivity on its technical concept first, and this refers to the relationship of the quantity of output, the goods and services that we produce versus the quantity of input that the resources that we use. So as a technical concept, it is the ratio of the output over the input, plus productivity. So other than the technical concept of productivity, we look at productivity in this perspective, the management concept. So that is the efficiency and the effectiveness equation. So both are together. So they should be together. So efficiency means doing things right the first time so that you are able to optimize the use of resources. You're able to make maximum use, of the resources that you have. While effectiveness means doing the right thing. So that means giving or producing the desired results, or output, And so these two should be together, for you to be considered as productive, So this provides the link or the connection between productivity and quality. So efficiency plus effectiveness. So meaning you produce the desired results. And so when we talk about efficiency, we talk about optimization on the utilization of resources, so that we eliminate waste. Productivity comes from the elimination of waste. And we have here the acronym or the mnemonics downtime to represent the 8 types of waste, which has been introduced to us by Toyota. So before, it used to be 7 waste, and it was represented by the acronym Team Woods. But now there is another type of waste that has been added. Okay, so what are these types of waste, represented by downtime? First, we have defects, So defects when there are reworks, rejects, because outputs are or work are poorly done, So it's of poor quality, So kaya binabalik, reject, so defect. So next is overproduction, So this is another type of waste in which we are able to produce more than what is needed, So yan, extra copies, of files, documents, that are not needed man. So that's an example, even at home, So when we cook so much food that we cannot eat, at one time, so it's a sayang. So that's overproduction. Waiting, so this happens when we wait, for people in meetings, when when people are sitting idly because they are waiting for the output of the other person or another office. So there's waiting time. So that's a waste. So when we wait for a meeting to get started, so and the next type of waste represented by N is non-utilized talent. This is actually the addition to the 7 types of waste. Ito yung pinaka-8 na dinagdag nila. So non-utilized talent, so this is the most common and most damaging type of waste. So in the organization, we find this. So ano yung mga, sino yung mga non-utilized talents? Ano yung example niyan? So if people are not given career dev, career dev and planning is absent, so yung training and development opportunities are not given to people, and if people who are highly skilled are given routine works, hindi na utilize the full potential of the people. Okay, so transportation happens when there is movement of people, yung items or equipment too often, or that which is moved or transported to further distances, that it may lead to damages and even exhaustion also fatigue doon sa tao na gumagawa. So then another type of waste is inventory. When we are able to store more than what is needed, like yung cabinet full of office supplies, so nag-i-stock tayo, nag-hoard tayo ng maraming office supplies. That's an example of inventory, and it's an example of waste. So motion, this refers to unnecessary movement of people within a work center, so that and this also happens when we neglect to perform or apply 5S, like for example unnecessary searching of files or items or equipment, so that it causes you to make extra movement or a lot of movement that are unnecessary. So it can cause exhaustion also, and it can so that doing this it can be very wasteful for the person doing unnecessary motion, so that this can be simplified yung process niyan, and 5S can help overcome it. And then extra processing, so when you do something more than which is necessary, like for example too much of the report information, so extra processing yon. So that's the 8 types of waste. So both public and private sector encounter these types of waste, the 8 types of waste. And if you are able to eliminate or reduce the occurrence of these types of waste, then we can realize productivity. Okay, so this type, these 8 types of waste affect public sector productivity. So can you think of these types of waste occurring or happening within our own organization? Okay, so it really affects public sector productivity. So in the equation of the productivity as to the management concept, so we have discussed about the efficiency dimension of it. So we move to the effectiveness dimension, and it is about doing the right thing, producing the right results or the right output. So in that case, that means we are able to give what is required, what is expected of us by our customers, and that comes in the concept of quality. Also, the connection between productivity and quality comes in. So what is quality ba? So we say it, I know it when I see it, diba? So just like in this example, so you can find different brands here. So these brands connote a certain type or level of quality. I know it when I see it, diba? As a customer. Okay? So but what does quality mean to us? What is really quality? So it refers to the degree to which a set of inherent characteristics fulfills requirements. So it refers to the totality of features and characteristics, the inherent traits, description, of the product or service, So ano yun, So that fulfills requirements, So yung characteristics refers to the attributes, The traits that make us buy, that make us buy the product or service, because it fulfills our requirements. What does requirements mean here? So it may be a stated, or implied need or requirement of us as a customer. Okay? So ano yung requirements na yun? Stated or implied, So like for example, so when you order, for food, okay? So like you order sinigang. So sinigang, ano ang characteristics niya? Anong attributes niya? So it should be maasim. And sinigang siya, it should be mainit. So you don't have to tell the store that you need it sinigang na hot siya. So it is part of your implied need. So stated need mo, it should be sinigang. Sinigang na bangus. So that's a stated requirement. So implied sinigang is maasim, and it should be served hot. Okay, so that's just a specific, a concrete example of how we can apply concept of quality. So that productivity is efficiency plus effectiveness. Okay, so that's the management concept. And the third concept of productivity refers to the social concept. So the social concept of productivity tells us that productivity is an attitude of the mind. So it refers to our belief, our conviction that we can make improvements. Based on the second line, it says it seeks to continually improve what already exists. So the concept or philosophy of continuous improvement comes in. So that productivity means continuous improvement. That's why you need perseverance. You need to be persevering when it comes to productivity, because it is a continuous improvement process. It cannot be a quick fix. It can't be done overnight. It has to be a gradual, continuous improvement. And it is based on the conviction, the belief that one can do things better today than yesterday and better tomorrow than today. DOA. So that so it still revolves, no, within the concept of continuous improvement. And this line refers to productivity, providing every one of us a better quality of life, no, for everyone. That's why better today than yesterday and better tomorrow than today. That's essentially continuous improvement that brings that will bring about, no, a better quality of life for us. Mm? So if we're practicing productivity, okay? And as part of that social concept, okay, we base from it, no, our PDCA cycle. Okay? So PDCA cycle is a management approach, no? It is a philosophy of continuous improvement. Plan, do, check, act. No? So that's where we base, no, the Deming cycle, no, Deming cycle, because it was Edward Deming, no, who introduced this PDCA cycle, no? So for us to make continuous improvement, so when we plan, okay, then we execute what we have planned, no? So in everything that we do, whether at work or at home, we start with a plan and we execute what we have planned, and based on our execution, we check what have we done, oh, based on what we have planned. And as we review, as we monitor, review what we have done, okay, so we make countermeasures, we act on it, okay? So that first to the next stage, which is act. And whatever we have done there as part of the countermeasures, we incorporate it to the next stage of the planning. That's when we turn the PDCA cycle. Okay, so that's a philosophy of continuous improvement. No? So if we have not done what we have planned, no? So we check, where are the opportunities for improvement here? Then we incorporate it, no, to the next phase of the planning, so we can do better. Okay, so that's essentially what the social concept mean. Okay, and okay, let's stop here first. No, we have a pop quiz, Jael. Okay, and we would like you to answer this, okay, the pub quiz, okay. So here the question is, the PDCA cycle refers to, okay, you have three choices, okay, to choose from. Okay, so A, the philosophy of continuous improvement, B, organizational learning, C, quality policy. Okay, so which do you think, oh, is the correct or the best answer? Okay, so we have a poll. Okay, so you can answer. You can choose from there, and you click the button submit for your answer to be included. The poll, Chel? Hindi daw siya makasali sa poll.
You can see the poll po on the right panel ng inyo pong mga screens if you're using the computer. But if you can see, you can just type it on the chat box po. Okay. Medyo dalawa lang po yata yung nakapag-access ng poll natin. So, it's okay. This is the first poll. We have more. So, matatry nyo po ang ating pop quiz. So, just be aware po on the right panel of your screen once we have a pop quiz para po masagutan nyo. But anyway, from the chat box po, Ma'am Tess, we have answers letter A po. Most of the answers are letter A.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. So, the correct answer is A. See? Ayun. The correct answer is A, the philosophy of continuous improvement. Okay? So, yeah. Congratulations. Thank you for your participation. Okay? So, we go to the next. Okay? So, yan. Okay. So still within the concept of within the social concept of productivity, there is that phrase, better tomorrow for everyone. No, better today than yesterday and better tomorrow. Okay. So it refers to achieving, no, a better tomorrow for everyone, no? That takes into consideration, no? What we have, no, for the quality of life that productivity brings to us, a better quality of life for everyone, no? So in this phrase, better tomorrow for everyone, no, under the social concept of productivity takes a renewed focus on health and safety of people, no, especially at this time, no, of the pandemic. Also, there is that focus, no, on the health and safety. So that constitutes, no, the individual well-being. Also, because a healthy and safe people brings out a healthy, happy, and productive, no, organization. Also, how can there be a productive organization if people are not healthy? So that it brings to mind, oh, that we need to be concerned about the well-being, oh, of our people in our organization. Okay, so becoming productive helps us to attain a better quality of life, oh, for everyone. Okay, so that's about the social concept of productivity. And at this point, we can be able to realize why productivity is important for us, no, to achieve, because it has its daily influence on the ability of individuals to earn a living. No? So if a person is productive, no, so that means you are capable of working, no, engaging, no, productively, no, in the work in your organization, and it will mean income for you, no, a source of living for you and your family. Also, no? That's individual productivity. Also, no? If all individuals are productive, you contribute, no, to organizational productivity. So that leads us to making our organizations productive, no, and viable. So we're able to produce, sell our goods and services, no. So if people are productive, they contribute to organizational productivity, and organizational productivity leads, no, to national productivity. So organizational productivity contributes, no, to the productivity of the national government. And through that, we'll be able to provide, no, the government will be able to provide services, no, to the people through the taxes that people and organizations pay. Also, that's the link, no? So at different levels, individual, organizational, national, no, productivity. So that's how important productivity is. So there's another quiz, okay, here. So we have this second pop quiz. So quality refers to A, stated and implied needs of customers, B, direct and indirect needs of customers. C, explicit and tacit needs of customers. So, what is your answer? You can use the poll. Is the poll working, Jel?
We have a technical glitch po on the polling, but for your answers, you can type it in the chat box for the meantime.
Okay.
Last 10 seconds. So from the chat box, ma'am, we have answers. And a letter A and C. Okay, time's up na po. Okay, mostly the answer is A, ma'am, from the chat box.
Yes. Okay, so correct answer is A. Okay, so yeah, thank you for your participation. Okay, so next, as we move to our discussion on productivity and quality, okay, so we in the public sector. Okay, so we are in the service, no, of the citizens, the Filipino people. Okay, so talking about, no, achievement of productivity and quality. So we come to our service quality, no, dimensions of our delivery of services to the citizens. No, so. Ano nga ba tong dimensions of service quality that we need to observe, no, as public sector organization? So this is represented by the acronym RATER. First, it is reliability, assurance, tangibles, empathy, and responsiveness. No? So there are five dimensions of service quality. So ano ba ito? Let's take a look at it. No? So, reliability is the ability to deliver the promised service dependably and accurately. Okay? Especially at this time, no, of the pandemic, the crisis situation. No? So, can our citizens, our customers who are the citizens, be able to depend on us, no? Be able to rely, no, on the delivery of our services. Ayan. Ability to deliver the promised service dependably and accurately. No? So consistently, are we able to deliver, no, the type of service that we have promised, no, to do? Or like, for example, ano yung mga to deliver the promised service dependably. So like when we go to the ATM, so di ba? So ano yung commitment sa atin, no, for that service delivery na yung services of the ATM should be available to us, no? 24/7, no? 7 days a week, no? And dapat makakapag-dispension ng pera at any time of the day, di ba? For us to be assured, no, na meron tayong serbisyong maaasahan. Okay? So, yan. Okay? And even, no, at the local government units, especially at this time of the pandemic, no, are we able to deliver the services that are expected of us, no, by the citizens that we serve. And A is assurance. Okay, so this refers to the level of knowledge, no? The knowledge of the person or of the employee, no? About the organization, the services that the organization provides, no? So other than dun sa can be product or service knowledge, so expected of the employee then is yung courtesy, politeness, no? Of the employee towards the customer or the citizen, because by doing that we are able to build, no, the trust and confidence, no, of our customers, no, you assure them, okay, so you are knowledgeable about the services that the organization provides to the citizen, and you are courteous, you are polite, no, in delivering the services. So that your customer has confidence, no, in you. So another dimension of service quality is the tangibles, no, that which are seen, no, by our citizens, no. So it refers to the appearance of the building or of the premises of the organization, the facilities, the equipment, as well as the employees, no. So, in this case, yung employees, how is it represented? Because when we wear our uniform, our office uniform, also complete uniform with the IDs, no? So that's part. Also, even if we are in a government agency, so we need to project, no, yung a very professional image, no, as government employees, no, and even yung ating building and facilities, no, although this can be different now, no, so may mga iba pang tangibles na titingnan sa atin as part of the new normal, no. So let's move to the next, which is E, the empathy. So here we have caring, individualized, personalized attention to our customers, no? So we put ourselves, no, into the shoes of our customers so that we relate, we know how they feel, how they experience, because what we are giving them, no, is actually the experience with the service that we provide them. No? So we put ourselves, no, in their shoes. No? How would we feel if we are the customer or the citizen that we serve? So we need to provide a caring, individualized attention. No? And, okay. Then the fifth service quality dimension is responsiveness. So this is the willingness to assist the customers, right, and to deliver prompt service. Also, you can see or you can observe, no, from the employee that there is that, no, willingness to serve, no? So even if from a distance, even from a phone call, you will be able to observe, no? Kung nakasmile ba yung tao habang nakikipag-usap sa'yo, no? So the responsiveness, so immediately to take action when you are raising a concern, no? So you listen, no? You are willing to listen, to assist, no, your customer and deliver the service promptly. Okay, so we have another pop quiz. There are how many service quality dimensions according to the service quality model? A is 4, B is 5, C is 7. Okay. Hey, Jel.
Keep your answers coming. Sa chat box po tayo mag-answer, because apparently the
Paul, function of the platform is not working at the moment. Okay, last 10 seconds.
Okay, I think yes. So the answer is B, 5. Okay, so congratulations and thank you for your participation. Okay, so there are 5 service quality dimensions. Kaya rater, RATER. Okay, next. Okay. Sunod pa to. Which service quality dimension refers to individualized and caring attention? Sympathy, empathy, and assurance. Assurance. So A, B, C. Which one refers to individualized and caring attention? Yeah. Okay, so Jel.
Okay, most of the answers, ma'am, ay letter B. Okay. Ano po ang correct answer?
Yes, the correct answer is B. Okay. That is empathy. Okay, so we move to the next. Thank you and congratulations. Okay, so after the service quality dimension, I would like to share with you this framework that we follow, no, as the DAP, no, serves as the National Productivity Organization. Okay, so you can find here at the base, the foundation for productivity and quality, we have 4 of the arrows going up. So that represents the 4 basic productivity and quality improvement tools. We have 5S, next is WIT or Work Improvement Team, represented by Quality Circle in the private sector because WIT is used in the public sector. SS is Suggestion Scheme and ISO 9001. Quality Management System. So all of these are covered or encompassed, no, by the umbrella of total quality management. Okay, and total quality management has as its principles, no, represented by the 7 arrows above it. No, so the 7 arrows above TQM represent the 7 criteria categories of the Philippine Quality Awards Framework or the Performance Excellence or Business Excellence Framework of our highest national recognition, which is the PQA. No? So leadership, no? Planning, customers, information, people, processes, and results. The first 6 categories refers to the processes and activities that we do as an organization. And all of these processes provide or give us, no, results, no, specific to our organization. So what type of results? So given all these processes, we should be able to give or yield, no, superior business results for our organization. And we do that, no, based on continuous improvement, no, all of these processes, so that we are able to attain, no, service performance excellence, no, as an organization. Okay, so that's how we look, no, at the use of the different productivity and quality improvement tools, no, to attain service performance excellence for the public sector. So these are just some of the tools that I would like to share with you, productivity and quality improvement tools that you can consider applying or adopting in your organization. We have 5S, suggestion scheme, quality circles or work improvement teams, so with quality management system, which I think most of you are already you have it in place, no? And we have lean management, okay, and business process streamlining, which is also anchored on lean management, and of course business excellence, no? Or it is often referred to as total quality management in the past, no? Business excellence program. So this is represented by our Philippine Quality Awards program, for the PQA program. So these are just some of the tools, and these are what we are advocating, we are implementing, no, for capability building, no, to both the public and the private sector, no, because these tools are universal, no, in application. So given this, no, do we find the relevance of attaining productivity and quality improvement even at this time of the pandemic, even at this time that we are transitioning to the new normal? So how do we find the applications of productivity and quality improvement in the new normal? So what are its relevance and benefits? So it can be represented by the mnemonics PQCDSM: productivity, quality, cost, delivery, safety, and morale, no? So these are the benefits, the relevance, no, of achieving productivity, quality. So let's take a look at it, okay? So how do we say we can find application of productivity, no? Even at this time, we're transitioning to the new normal. So we have alternative work arrangements so that even if there is disruption caused by the pandemic, so we are able to cope up, no, with the crisis situation. So we have alternative work arrangements. We work from home, so we work remotely. So we do virtual learning sessions like this, no? So that connotes, no, productivity for us. And even in other government agencies like the LGUs, the local government units, they are also working, no, to attain or demonstrate productivity in their respective, no, localities or jurisdiction. Like here in this case of the LGU San Fernando Romblon, In this time of the pandemic, they were able to find a demonstration of productivity in their program Bahay Ko, Garden Ko, by setting up, no, an executive order directing all households to have, no, as part of their program implementation, a backyard garden in which the produce from this serve as a source of livelihood, no, for people, so that it helps them, no, from preventing, no, virus infection, also because they get to eat healthy foods, no, and a source of livelihood because there were many people also have been displaced at that time, so they have something, no, to get, no, from their backyard for their food. And also what the LGU Bacoor City has done, no, so they signed up, no, a memorandum of agreement as a partnership with Food Panda Philippines, no, Joyride or Happy Move Company, to provide employment to displaced workers, no, so displaced tricycle drivers and other workers that will likely get unemployed because of the disruption of the pandemic, but they were able, no, to provide them employment because of this. So that's productivity on the part of the government. Also, so people will not depend on the subsidy, no, from the government. And they are also able to set up online job applications. So they are able to connect, no, people to possible or potential employers. Okay, so this is an example of how productive our government agencies are. And quality, no, because if our agencies are able to deliver, no, responsibly and with the services on time, no? So we bring about citizen satisfaction. Okay, and because of the public and private sector collaboration, we are able to reduce cost also for the government. We're able to have optimum utilization of the resources. Also, private sector are also able to contribute. So it lessens, you know, the burden of government agencies. And in terms of delivery, we are able to observe, no, quick response service delivery. So this is a display of agility, no, being able to respond quickly, no, to changing, no, situations or environment. And the delivery of services, both by the public and the private sector, is also a demonstration of their corporate social responsibility. So both organizations, public and private, are able to demonstrate good corporate citizenship. So best practices that we can think of here, no, in the times of the pandemic, that we're able to deliver quick, no, responsive services to people. So Mayor on Wheels, so this is part of the program of LGU San Mateo Rizal. Also, so there's a van, no, that rove around. So it's like a mini municipio roving around, no, the municipality to provide services to the people. So they can be easily accessible and they reach out to many people. Okay, so the Bank on Wheels. So this is another type of very good service delivery at this time of the pandemic. The Market on Wheels. So there are also LGUs doing this. Okay, so even at this time of the pandemic. Okay, so safety. Okay, so this refers to taking care, no, of the health and safety, no, the well-being of our people. Okay, so how is this demonstrated? Also, we have the community quarantine, the health and safety protocols that have been implemented and adhered to by the people. Okay, so that refers to safety dimension of the benefits and relevance and morale. Okay, so this refers to the level, no, of satisfaction of people, no, for the services that they have received. So citizen satisfaction, no, as we transition to the new normal. So some of the practices that are done, the mental health awareness sessions and also online team building sessions, no, to put all people at ease with one another, even at this time of the crisis situation. No? So it pays to get connected at this time. So this is not the old normal that we are in. So we all find this as part of the relevance and benefits, no, of achieving productivity and quality in the organization. So as I conclude, we can all create an impact and make a difference in public service delivery. Okay, so I wish you all the best, no, in your service delivery to the people for your respective agencies. Okay, so thank you for your attention, and we would like to invite you for our other programs on productivity and quality. And Chell, okay.
All right. Thank you very much, Ms. Tess, for that enriching discussion about productivity and quality. So I noticed the time. It's already 10:54. I would like to ask everyone if it's okay for you to extend for 15 more minutes for the open forum. Should you have any questions, can you please reply in the chat box so we will know? All right. Sige po. Thank you very much for the response. Okay, we will have 15 minutes more. Final na po yun, including the last minute reminders before we officially end. If you have questions, please use the Q&A portion of the platform, or you can use the chat box po if you cannot find the Q&A. Ma'am Tess, earlier we have a question po. What's the difference between continuous improvement and continual improvement? Or are these equivalent, ma'am, please?
Yes. Actually, they are just the same, no? But you know, there's this school of thought, no? So continuous improvement, so that means so you never stop, no? So for gradual improvement. And continual improvement, that's often we encounter, no, in a quality management system, ISO 1001. So continual because there is that connotation that the improvement can be done on a periodic basis, no, be periodic because there is that evaluation or audit that is done, no, continual improvement. Okay, so, but they are just the same. Also, yon, in the context of the QMS, kaya siya sinasabi na continual improvement, merong audit, periodic evaluation. Yon.
All right. By the way, that question is from Edmund Galamaso. All right. Thank you po for that. We have another question. Among the PQI tools, which tool is better to use?
So
from GM Tabaco.
It depends on the need of your organization. But the most basic of the productivity and quality improvement tool is the 5S. No? So we start from there as it is the foundation for setting a productivity and quality improvement culture. And even at this time of the pandemic, no, we find, no, its usefulness, and you know, it's very helpful, no, if you can be able to find how to customize, no, the use of 5S in your respective organization in the context of the new normal, no? How do you find concrete applications, no, of it?
Ayan, thank you very much, Ma'am Tess. Another question po from Miss Madonna Carlos. Can you give us a general outline kung paano po online team building?
Online team building, online team building session. So these are done by organizations at this time of the pandemic. I think most of the private organizations. So it's just some sort of structured learning activities that are done virtually. No, so it can be simple exercises to get connected, to unleash all of those emotional and psychological concerns in working with teams. No? So, mga structured learning activities or exercises yan. So, yung online team building sessions. Actually, ours in the DAP Productivity and Development Center will be coming up with our implementation of that team building session. So it starts with the idea comes from our office, training office.
All right. Okay, we hope that answers your question, Ma'am Madonna. Another question po, what are some tips you can give us on enhancing productivity and quality on our own areas or in ourselves? And how can we tell if improving our own productivity practices directly affect our organizations?
Ah, okay. Actually, for you to start up with your productivity and quality improvement initiatives, okay? So, you can actually start with a productivity and quality diagnosis. No? The productivity and quality diagnosis can cover conducting a morale survey for all employees to be able to determine, no? The willingness, the readiness of employees in the organization to engage or participate, no, in productivity and quality improvement programs. No? So from there, from the conduct of the morale survey, okay, you can find, no, the readiness of the people. So that's in terms of the people. In terms of the work environment, okay, you can actually do a situation appraisal. So that will help you determine the level of workplace organization. No? So that you can design workplace organization programs through 5S. No? So you can start with implementing 5S in areas that it is most needed. Okay. So that's, I think, how you can start, no? And so after doing those activities, okay, you can make another round, no, of productivity and quality diagnosis. But if you are really very serious about all these productivity and quality improvement initiatives, okay, we have another approach for diagnosing the organizational health, and that is through our organizational self-assessment using the business excellence framework or the performance excellence framework. So if you're open to that, we have our organizational self-assessment pack. And we provide it for free to organizations. We can conduct a free orientation on the Government Excellence Class Organizational Self-Assessment and also on the Philippine Quality Award. Okay. So yon. So parang dami kaya't na sinabi. So those are two approaches in which you can start, no? Productivity and quality improvement initiative.
Sige po. We have 7 minutes remaining and we still have a few more questions left unanswered. The next question is from Ms. Mariel Amy Malinaw. Question is crisis management system the same with business continuity plan?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I think that is part of the business continuity plan, no? Or business continuity program of the organization. So that's where you can be able to apply, no? Organizational resiliency. No.
Ay, sorry, nakamute po tayo, ma'am. Ulitin ko po the question from Kevin De Ramos. Aside from organizational perspective, how do we engage non-technical individuals in transition to the new normal in relation to productivity and quality improvement since digital and online approaches are the new kind of services?
Okay.
Naka-mute po kayo, ma'am.
Ayan. Yes, yes. Okay. I think even if we are doing our work virtually or remotely, there are different ways of reaching to all of the people in the organization. There has to be a communication plan for you to better deploy the initiatives that you will be doing. So that it reaches all levels of the organization from the top down. Okay, so you can actually come up with creative, innovative approaches to be able to engage people. Okay, so I think right now, what should be our focus or entry point for introducing these changes in the new normal is that we have this strong focus on the health and safety of people, our people. And I think that is the prime consideration of every organization, every individual at this time, health and safety. So that's where we, I think we can find an entry point for encouraging our employees, all employees, to be involved, okay, to be engaged. So engage is a deeper term, because it connotes commitment and the motivation to participate. So health and safety. So I understand how difficult it is right now to work virtually and to communicate down the line. But there are different communication mechanisms.
Okay. Ma'am, meron pong follow-up question on that. Can you mention some of these innovative approaches? Nire-refer po sa PNQ improvement in the new normal po siguro.
Okay. Okay. So what I can think of in line with the productivity and quality improvement approaches, and this is what I have included in the list of productivity and quality improvement tools, the suggestion scheme. Suggestion scheme. You can actually set up a suggestion scheme for your organization. The suggestion scheme is actually a two-way approach of communication between management and employees. So you will be able to solicit creative ideas from people. So this is at the individual level. So through that, you will be able to unleash their creativity, and their oneness, with the organization to make improvements, So because implementing suggestion scheme will follow a certain theme to be observed per project cycle. Like for example, we are transitioning to the new normal, so there is this health and safety, or you can even label as a team, like transition to the new normal. So you can come up with a first theme that you will introduce as part of the suggestion scheme, like your creative ideas on the transition to the new normals. Then people will get to share no, their creative ideas through the suggestion scheme. But of course, it's different. The suggestion scheme is different from the suggestion box. No? We have a particular course, no? It's a one-day course, no, on suggestion scheme for you to be able to know the details.
Okay, sige po. Thank you po for all your questions, and we hope you got your expected answers. Apparently, that will be our last question. For those questions po na na-raised na hindi pa po nasagutan, we will answer them via email. And if you have more questions po, you can email it to the excuse me, the email address that I will send po dito sa ating chat box. All right. Before we end, I would just like to give a few more reminders. Please accomplish the evaluation form for this webinar. It can be accessed through this link nasa chat box po ulit. And should you need a certificate of appearance for this webinar, we have a request form which is also in the chat box. So bali tatlong reminders na sa chat box natin for your questions, for the evaluation form for this webinar, and for the request for certificate of appearance. So with that, wala na po akong ibang reminders. Pwede na po tayong maghiwa-hiwalay to continue on our daily operations. Ano po? And I would like to thank Ms. Tess Agustin for her very in-depth explanation of the productivity and quality introduction. So if you are interested to know more about productivity and quality improvement approaches, do not hesitate to get in touch with us, because we offer several programs on this line of course. All right. So with that, thank you very much for attending the webinar, and we hope to see you again on our next courses.
Okay, Jel, may we also invite them if there are agencies interested to join, no, our 5S program for the public sector, no? So they can express interest to be part of the beneficiary agencies of 5S, no, for the year, no? So if you will be selected as part of the beneficiary agency, then you can be included in the capability building program, no, that we have for the remaining part of the year on 5S. So you can submit your application to us. Oh, okay. Sige.
Are interested po, please get in touch with us so we can talk to you about the 5S program of our office. Okay.
Okay.
For the presentation materials, it will not be sent to you, but the video of the webinar will be uploaded on our you want.
Okay.
We'll also email the forms needed. You can just click the link right now po for your reference na lang po. Yes, Ma'am Tess.
Yes, so if they're interested to participate in the selection process, I mean, to be considered as a beneficiary agency for 5S, maybe they can submit an expression, they can submit a letter, because we have our application form on that. So you just get in touch with our project team.
Internet connectivity issues at the moment. Ma'am Tess.
Hello? Hello?
Queries about our has informed you about, you can email us anytime po. So with that, thank you very much, and that we hope to see you on our next courses.
And Jel, kindly promote to them. They can watch the GBPR presentation tomorrow and Thursday. and to join the PQA.
All right. For tomorrow po, we will be having the government best practice recognition, best practice entries finalist po presentation to the judges. You can watch it via the YouTube channel of our office. You can find the necessary links po on the DET Facebook page. And on December, we will be having the third batch of the public offering po ng Philippine Quality Award Application Development Course. Okay. All right. For the email address po, you can send all your inquiries to the email address I will send here in the chat box. Okay, it's 11:15 na. So wala na po talaga kaming announcement. Pasensya na po for keeping you a bit longer. But wala na po. Maraming salamat po for participating with us. Thank you and have a good day.